afternoon, one and all present over here. Today we have all gathered here for a webinar, which is the need of the hour, managing emotional well-being during COVID-19 crisis, organizing by IQAC and Department of Commerce of Annavalet Arts and Science College. I, Hima of third year, BCom, feeling privileged to welcome you all for this webinar. Please make use of the chat box to post your questions regarding webinar topics during the session. Once the presentation gets over, your questions will be answered. Students and faculties are requested to fill the feedback form to receive the e-certificate, which will be posted in the chat box once the session gets over. God speaks in the silence of the heart. Listening is the beginning of prayer. I request the AVC choir to start off with a prayer song.
Count your many blessings, see what God has done. When a poor life billows you, a tempest starts. When you are discouraged, thinking all is lost. Count your many blessings, name them one by one. And it will surprise you what the Lord has done.
Thank you, friends. Our desire is to extend a gracious and inclusive welcome to all of you. I would like to invite Ms. Bhavani Ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, to welcome the gathering. Over to Bhavani Ma'am.
Thank you, Hema. A very good evening to one and all present here. This is Ms. Bhavani, is here to present a welcome address. On behalf of our college, I welcome our chairman, Sevalier, Dr. N.R. Ganapalan, our energetic secretary, Mr. N.R.D. Premkumar, our dynamic joint secretary, Dr. P.R. Premchand, our beloved principal, Dr. Kamala Balakrishnan, vice principal and IQAC coordinator, Mrs. Jafria Solomon, and head of the Department of Commerce, Dr. Uma Charlatta. I also extend a warm welcome to the energetic woman, guest speaker of the day, Ms. Komati Rajendran, training and education facilitator. On behalf of all, I extend my warm welcome to heads of various departments, faculty members, participants from various colleges, and my dear students. Once again, I welcome you all. Have a great evening. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now it's time to introduce our chief guest, and I invite Mrs. Meera Ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce. Over to Meera Ma'am.
Meera Ma'am, unmute.
I feel extremely honored to introduce our chief guest, Ms. Gomati Rajendran, a senior analyst and trainer in BNP Paribas for reconciliation team. Having completed her business administration, she started her career in Royal Bank of Scotland and then moved to General. With her enormous experience in corporate training, ma'am is a renowned soft skill trainer. Also, ma'am is a tutor and conducts session for GSO hubs in various colleges. We are very glorious to have you, ma'am. Once again, I welcome you and we are all awaiting for your presentation.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Okay. That was a very brief introduction. Thank you. About the topic, the discussion that we are here, managing emotional well-being during COVID-19 crisis. The WHO, the World Health Organization, declared COVID-19 as a pandemic in March 2020. And it's been more than a year and still we are struggling with this. Okay. And from the pandemic, now we have found something called black fungus and white fungus, which they call it as an epidemic. I hope you all watched the news today. So yeah, we're all in lockdown. We're all stressed. We all have problems with our emotions and our mental health. So this outbreak is very stressful, not just for you and me, the entire world. Okay, so for the next 1 hour, we're going to discuss about the emotional health. Okay, I have my laptop here, so I often move it here, so please don't mind. I'm Gomati Rajendran. I've been doing this for the past few years, 2 to 3 years, I guess. And public speaking is something which I've never been scared of. Okay, but I'm extremely nervous today. This camera conscious and something which I've never done in my life, and talking by sitting in one place, which I've never done in my life. I completely understand and relate to all the teachers and lecturers who are undergoing this for the past 1 year. Extremely tough. Okay, I understand. And yeah, by having my emotions stable, I think I can tackle the session and move on. Okay, so yeah, I hope the slides are visible. For the emotional health, there are 7 dimensions of wellness. Okay, physical health, mental health are the most frequently discussed topics. Okay, they are very common. All of us know physical health and mental health. Okay, the least discussed is emotional health, okay, which we're going to discuss today. And the other dimensions of wellness is social, intellectual, spiritual, and financial health. Okay, so to break the topic, what are emotions? Okay. Emotions are psychological states which comprises of our thoughts, feelings, and our behaviors. Okay. Types of emotions. Okay. Happiness, sadness, fear, disgust, and anger. Okay. All of us know these emotions, right? I'm very pretty sure that all these emotions we have come across and we know what these emotions are, okay? Emotional health is difficult to define because it is very difficult to define because it differs from one culture to the other culture. In some culture, talking openly about your emotional feelings is encouraged. But in few culture, it is not encouraged. It is strictly something which they don't do it. Okay, so it is difficult to define, but there is a common definition where they say it is a person's ability to accept and damage feelings through challenge and change, okay? It is how we feel, okay? It is how we think, and it is about the wellness. It is how we cope up with our life events, okay?
how we acknowledge our emotions when it bursts out. It is not only with you, but and also with others. How you deal it with others, okay? How you deal your emotions with others. Emotional well-being is not that you... It doesn't mean that you're always happy. You should always be happy. No, it is not that. It is something where you should be able to tackle all the emotions that you come across. When you're sad, you should know how to react. When you're angry, you should know how to react. Okay, so it is about how you tackle your emotions. It is not that eliminating the other emotions and crowning only happiness. Okay, I don't know how many of you have watched the movie Inside Out, and a famous animation movie. Yeah, just a moment. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, you are audible.
Okay. We are on the fourth slide now. I hope you're also able to see my slides.
Great, ma'am.
Yeah?
Hey, Ram, sir, you want to share the screen slides? Sir?
Yeah.
1 minute, 1 minute.
Yeah, that will be better.
Sir, you know, sir, Bhavani ma'am only sharing the screen, sir.
Bhavani ma'am?
Yeah, sir. Yeah, no current.
Bhavani ma'am? Bhavani ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Just a minute.
Yeah.
Sir, it is visible, sir.
No, ma'am, you are not yet shared your screen, ma'am.
Now, sir?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Yes, okay. Ma'am, can you please move on to the next slide?
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Thank you. Okay. Yeah. Yes, I was talking about the movie Inside Out. I don't know how many of you had watched the movie. It is about the emotions that we have. What if our emotions have voices? Okay. It is an excellent movie about emotions. I want all of you to watch the movie. Okay. In general, the moral of the story, of the moral of the movie is sadness is also one of the most important and necessary emotion for us to experience the failure. Okay. Please do watch it. Ma'am, can you please move to the next slide? Okay. Yeah, we were talking about the most frequently discussed topic, physical health and mental health. Often mental health and emotional health are confused. Mental health is how our brains think and function. And emotional health is how we express the feelings and emotions. Okay, both are different, but generally people tend to confuse with mental health and emotional health. When we have a mental health, the first thing that we need to do is immediately consult the best doctor and get help. Okay, emotional health is something which we can control and which we can try at least to do something on it. But when it comes to mental health, we need assistance from some experts. Okay. When the mental health and the emotional health are very strong, we feel different aspects of our life. It makes changes when necessary to restore the balance. Okay. Mental health and emotional health are intertwined. We cannot take them apart. We have to, when we talk about mental health, we have to talk about the emotional health as well. Okay. Moving on to the next slide. I have the warning signs. Okay. The warning signs are like the symptoms of emotional health, the disorder, but I don't want to use the word symptom. We're all done with the word symptom. So I have used the term signs. So the warning signs of emotional health, okay? Personality changes is the top one which I have given, because when you know a person personally, okay, you may notice a sudden or a gradual change in their behavior, okay? You know a person who used to be very quiet, or someone who is very talkative, but their changes, their behavior changes completely, which they are not, which is not their nature, okay? To seem a very different person, okay? That is personality changes. Their values, their personal values itself will change when the personality changes, okay? When somebody's personality changes, it means that you need to connect with them and let them know that it is going wrong. And secondly, it is agitated. Agitated is someone who is very uncontrollable, angry, anxious, and very moody. Frequent problems they have. You may notice a person who has more frequent problems controlling their tempers. Someone who cannot control their temper. Okay, and you are not able to calm down. Also, you're trying to calm down them, but they are, you're not able to control them. Okay, but usually they are not that, okay? But when their emotional health is problem, you find it very difficult to calm them down. And people in more extreme situations, they will not be able to sleep. They cannot sleep. They have some problem or the other problem running in their mind, okay? And people, the same people, you'll find them very difficult to handle, even for minor problems, even for problems like stamping leg. See, you and your friend used to play by stamping their leg, but all of a sudden, the same stamping leg could have been a problem to them, okay, which is a problem to them. So it could be anything. You make fun of your friend always, but all of a sudden, even that makes them anger, okay? So all these are common changes you will find when they are agitated. Next is withdrawn. Social withdrawal. People isolate themselves from other people. Someone who used to be very socially engaged, they always spend their time with family, friends, okay, and parties, but all of a sudden they stop talking to others. And most importantly, we are not talking about the introvert, okay? Introvert are generally like that. They don't like interacting with people, okay? They like to be alone. We are not supposed to disturb them. They are different, okay? But who are used to be very friendly and very engaging in social gatherings, but they take away from those gatherings, they stop being attentive to those gatherings. When someone is very typically sociable, but now they have put themselves away from gatherings, we have to check what is the problem with them. We are supposed to talk to them what the problem is. And poor self-care, okay? Poor self-care is someone who stopped themselves from taking care of their needs, okay? When it comes to poor self-care, all of us know drinking is bad, okay? All of us know it is harmful, but you do it in spite of knowing it is harmful, okay? You don't care about it. So it is something which, again, need an attention. Last, hopelessness. Hopelessness is, again, it isn't the last warning sign, but it is also one of the most important warning signs compared to the others, because it triggers you to take wrong decisions, okay? They seem overcome with hopelessness and overwhelmed by their circumstances. Have you ever noticed someone used to be very optimistic and suddenly they can't find anything hopeful in this country? And like they feel their life is waste, or they feel they are in a situation where they say the world would be better if they're not alive. Okay. All these behavioral changes which they undergo, all this has to be really taken care. When it goes beyond their limit, when it goes beyond the limit, they would even think of suicides. So hopelessness is something which we really need to take care. Moving on to the next slide. I have a quick. It is my most favorite quote. Emotional pain is not something that should be hidden and never spoke about. There is truth in your pain. There is growth in your pain, but only if it is brought out into the open. Okay, so somebody can help only when you talk about it. Unless you talk about it openly to someone else, we will never know what you are undergoing. Okay, so everybody here, always when you have a problem, contact the right person. Okay, that is very important. Contact the right person. Okay, and tell them your problems and tell them, see, this is what I'm undergoing and I need help. Okay, choosing the right person is the most important. Okay, and moving on to the next slide. Mom, can we please move to the next slide? Okay. What are the risks? Okay. I've got all these problems. Okay. I've got all the signs. Okay. What if I have all these signs? We move from down, from bottom to top. Violence. All of us know what is violence. Okay. But what it causes, it may cause even a life. It may cause even someone else's life. Okay. Violence leads to actions which are not good. Okay. I hope you all know, we're all aware of acid victims. Violence ends up with such cases. Okay. The second from bottom is bad addiction. We have a lot to talk about bad addiction in the coming slides. We'll talk about them in detail. No goals. Okay. A life without goals, I really don't understand how it would be. Okay. So I really cannot even think about a life without goals. Every human being should have some goals in their life. Okay. So when you do not have a goal, you do not have anything to achieve. Okay. So that also leads to your mental problems. Loss of interest. Again, you are living a life where you should show your interest in something, either work, okay, either with your family or something. You should have some interest in life, okay. And if you lose interest in everything, again, it is a problem. And yeah, coming to the most important risk is suicidal thoughts, just like the one which I was talking about in the previous slide. Suicidal thoughts and actions are extremely bad, and mental health and emotional health leads them to do such actions. This also has to be spoken to somebody and get it done. Okay, we'll move on to the next slide. It is about the addictions which I was talking about in the previous slides. Okay, addiction and mental illness, okay, does one cause each other? Absolutely, yes. It is just an S answer, straight S answer. Okay. Addiction is an abnormal condition affecting the brain and behavior. Okay. That is addiction. Okay. What does it do? It does affect your mental illness. And when you have mental illness also, it affects your brain. Okay. So it is a straight S answer. And among, I have five addictions in the list, and I have the internet addiction at the top. It is something which is least discussed among us. It is something which nobody cares about. I don't even know whether few people know it is an addiction. It is actually an addiction which nobody is bothered about. Okay. For this session, I had one of my friends to talk with about internet addiction. She is a psychiatrist, and she forced me to have this internet addiction on the top, because she said, please talk about this to the younger generation. Please let them know what internet addiction is and what it causes. Okay, so yeah. Internet addiction, it is not just for the teenagers. These days, you can see all the age groups using internet. Okay, we have our grandparents using YouTube for some songs and all that. And we have our parents using it to watch some videos, and we are using it for the social media. And yeah, so internet addiction is not just for the teenagers. It is for the entire age group, for all the age groups, which is highly risky. And during this lockdown, we can see everybody using the internet, and it is something which needs attention, okay? I'm not saying do not use social media, okay? I'm not saying don't use internet. I'm just saying please be watchful, okay? Please be vigilant. You can use internet, but everything has its own limit. I hope you can see in the slide. Know your limits, okay? You should be very watchful. What are you watching, okay? And how long are you watching it, okay? Okay, you can use Facebook. You can use Instagram, you can use Twitter, you can use whatever you want. But please be sure, please make sure that you're using it only for a timeline. Have a timeline, use Facebook for 1 hour, okay? And then use Instagram for 1 hour and you're done, okay? So please be watchful and vigilant when you're using social media. Everybody is using social media. And are we very vigilant in what we are watching? No, whatever comes, whatever you want, we are using it. So internet addiction, I request all of you to please be very watchful. Okay, moving on to the next addiction, gaming addiction. Yeah, gaming addiction, again, internet addiction and gaming addiction is one and the same. You cannot play games without an internet connection. Gaming addiction is what? Is uncontrolled use of video games, which leads to gaming addiction. In a way, it causes problems in one's personal life also. I don't know whether you know, there are many divorce cases applied because of video games as well. Okay, so it affects your personal life. There are people who don't take bath. There are people who don't eat, don't sleep. And yet they play games the whole day. So it is very risky. And according to the American Academy of Pediatrics, they say you're not supposed to play games more than 2 hours a day. They do not recommend not more than 2 hours. So, but I'm not really sure whether we are following that. Okay, and in 2019, WHO classified gaming addiction as a disorder, disorder as a mental health condition. And you know what gaming addiction does, okay? Sleepless nights, which is highly risky. When you lose your sleep, you lose the entire day of your time. So it is very risky. Third is sex addiction. Sexual addiction is when you're unable to control your urge despite knowing the harm and consequences it leads to. All of us know what it is. All of us know what it leads to. But still, it is uncontrolled. Okay, obsessive sexual thoughts, spending excessive time on pornography. See, sex addiction leads to rapes. Okay, all of us know what sex addiction leads to, but how are we going to control it? That is the most important thing, which most of us doesn't do, which is not practiced in India also, sex education. I believe sex education can help sex addiction. Okay. Yeah. And drug addiction, sex addiction and drug addiction are similar. Okay. They co-occur. So at times they may differ, but they always co-occur. Drug addiction, you know what it is. It includes smoking, alcohol, consumption of drugs. Okay. Any form of drug is harmful. Okay. It is not that smoking is okay and drugs are bad. Any form of drugs is harmful. Smoked, injected, or swallowed. Okay. All three are bad for your health. All of us know. And just like the sex education prevents from sex addiction, I also believe drug education also prevents students from falling for it. Yeah. And there is, it not only affects you, it also affects the society. I'm talking about the drug addiction and sex addiction. It not only affects you, but it also affects the society. Okay, and food addiction. Food addiction is not currently an official mental illness, but it is soon to be. Okay, we're all influenced by the food delivery apps. Okay, there are a lot of food delivery apps, and they trigger us to eat something which you don't need, and which, when you're not angry, hungry also. Okay, they make you to eat something, and that food addiction, it is soon to be mental illness, just like the way they added gaming addiction recently in 2019. I think food addiction also will be included in the mental illness. To the next slide. I have two pictures for you. I hope you remember the first quote that I was telling about the pain. Yeah, we understand that you are in pain. We understand that addiction, pain leads to addiction, but you need to work on it to find the root cause, and you need to talk to someone about it. Okay, and on the right side of the slide, I hope you can read it. 7 million people suffer from drug use disorder. It is not the least number, it is a huge number. Okay, and 1 in 4 deaths is attributed to alcohol, tobacco, and drug use, which is a high number. It is highly risky, and the younger generation is in trouble. It is something which all of us need to concentrate on. Moving on to the next slide. These addictions can touch anyone, okay? I have one small point to be added with the previous slide. These addictions can touch anyone at any time, at any place. It can be schools, it can be colleges, it can be even at office, okay? But what will help them to revisit their or rethink on their addiction is the educators, the school, college, and educators should come together to help them. about the drug addiction, we know what it leads to. Okay, so only education can fix these issues and help the younger generation to understand the consequences. The students also should know the importance of education. All these addictions, it not only affects you, it also affects the society, and to be a better citizen, you should eliminate these addictions from your life. And about this, what are the things that we are supposed to follow in our life to eradicate and to come out from the problems that we have related to mental health? Okay, the first one which I have is physical health. Okay, I was talking about the most frequent topics discusses physical health and mental health. As I said earlier, mental health and emotional health are intertwined. In the same way, physical health is also intertwined, okay, interconnected. When you have a mental problem, they ask you to work out, okay? When you have a physical problem, they ask you to meditate, okay? So it is all interconnected. All the three are important: physical, emotional, and mental. All the three healths are very, very important. Physical health, as I was telling you, please engage yourself with some sport, okay? Some sport, it can be anything. Even if you're not good at it, please put yourself in some sport. It is very, very important. In specific to this lockdown, I have my friends who have gained 10 kgs to 15 kgs in last 1 year. Okay, so physical health only will help you to help you with mental health. Okay, and eating right food. Yeah, eating right food, again, all of us know what is right food and what is bad. Okay, all the junk food are bad, but we cannot be without eating it. I understand. I know that I can't relate. But the problem is, how much do we eat? Okay, we cannot eat junk food all the 3 times in a day or entire week. So eat healthy, eat right food. They say for the mental health, nuts and berries helps. Okay, they say it really helps for the mental health and emotional health. And I recently read an article where it says ashgard, the white pumpkin. They say it actually helps for They say it cleanses your thoughts. They say it helps in mental health. So yeah, you can try that. Even I've never tried it before, but I recently read about it. So I think that is something which we can try. And music, yeah. All of us know what music does, okay? It heals. It helps us to heal whatever we are struggling with, okay? So it differs from person to person. The music which I like may not be your favorite, and your favorite may not be mine. So you can choose yours, and you can use music for your therapy, music as a therapy, okay? Sport, music are very, very important. You should be engaging yourself with any of these two or both. Yeah, and connect with nature. Yeah, connecting with nature, we cannot go out now, but we can do something about it. You can go to your terrace, you can have a cup of coffee near the window, okay? These days we are watching even sunrise and sunsets in phones, in mobile phones. We are watching it as videos. That's not good, okay? So connect with nature. I think very hardly we touch soil, which I myself don't remember when was the last time I touched soil. So connect with nature. And last is be clean. being clean is not brushing, washing your hair, taking bath. When they mean being clean here is cleaning your colon, your stomach. Okay. In Ayurveda and in the in medical sides, they say you in from the time you wake up in less than 20 minutes, okay, in 20 minutes or less than 20 minutes, you should clean your stomach. I mean, the stool should be away, should be out. Okay, so you should clean, you should keep that clean. You should keep your place very clean because constipation is something which leads to all the problems. Okay, not just the physical health, it also leads to mental health and emotional health. So keeping your colon clean is very, very important for mental health. Okay, and I have the next slide, ma'am. Yeah, here, whatever we have discussed before is the broader version or is a broader points, okay? But few things which we can do here, do for a better mental health is develop your interest, okay? Taking me as an example, I like calligraphy, okay? I like to write in calligraphy font, okay? So I started watching videos and I started writing it on my own. So you, whatever interest you have, I have a couple of my friends who started terrace farming, and few of my friends who started sketching, which they did in their school days, and now they started doing it again. Likewise, any interest, whatever is your interest, start doing that now. This is the right time. You have enough time to concentrate on your interest. Okay, and make me time a priority. I don't know about the students, but this is something which is highly necessary for all the elders, I mean, to the lecturers and the professors, making time for themselves. I've seen parents who don't even sit and drink their tea and coffees. Okay, so just have a time, just make time for yourself. Grab a chair, sit in a corner, take a cup of coffee with no disturbance. Okay. And if you feel like having a mask over your face, please do it. So whatever, make time for yourself. Whatever make you feel happy, please do it. And nurture and value your relationship. Yeah. See, we're all at home, but we very hardly talk to people because we're all engaged in mobile phones. Okay, so please prioritize and spend time with your parents, okay, pets, whatever you have at home. Make your relationship stronger, okay? At this point of time, it is very, very important. So make your relationship stronger. Make a timetable. Yeah. Timetable is, I understand that you have your classes, understand you have your assignments, you have your exams and all that. And in the meantime, you have to do your interest. And in the meantime, you should clean your colon, all that. I understand that you've got all of these things to do. But you can achieve all of this only when you make a timetable. Okay, I often make a timetable. I whether follow it or not, but I make a timetable for myself. Okay, even for today, I made a timetable for the day where it started from 8 o'clock in the morning, like cooking, my office, and my lunch. So yeah, getting ready like that, I made a timetable. So always make a timetable. Start making a timetable. You following it or not is different. Okay, but start making a timetable. You will also understand what is time management when you start making a timetable, okay? And then positivity. This is the most used common term, okay? Stay positive, be positive, spread positiveness, all that, yeah. So be positive. Whatever it happens for a reason. Okay, calm down and just go in the flow. And stop overthinking. Yeah, stop overthinking is I don't know whether you have come across this, but I have few of my friends, my age group, not my parents' age group, my age group, where they watch some serial or watch some movie, and they come back saying, after watching the serial, they say, what if this happens to me? Okay, they put themselves in that situation and make things worse for themselves. Okay, they overthink on something which is not going to happen or which may or may not happen in the future. Okay, so stop overthinking. That is something which I think most of the youngsters are into that. Okay, social media also helps them to do that. Okay, it leads them to that. Something had happened somewhere, and what if that happens to me? Okay, so stop overthinking. And yeah, last, it is meditation. Yeah, I was talking about the physical health and mental health, where for better physical health, they ask you to do meditation, right? So meditation is for physical health, mental health, and emotional health. Okay, we need meditation for all the three. Okay, in the beginning, it is very tough even to concentrate and sit for 1 minute. But later, you can move on from 1 minute to 5 minutes, 5 minutes to 10 minutes, and 10 minutes to 15 minutes. And then you can keep moving it. But at least for now, try for 1 minute. Okay. Yeah, meditation is mandatory, and that will help you to have a well-being of physical, mental, and social emotional health. Okay. And yeah, moving on to the next slide. Okay, the slide is not visible. Okay, moving on. Yeah, I've got a quick stats. Yes, thank you, sir. I've got quick stats. Okay, as per the World Health Organization's statistics, they say we have only 3 psychiatrists and psychologists for 100,000 population. Okay, only 3. Look at the number that needs psychiatrists. So we should take care of ourselves and help others, okay? And WHO estimates 56 million Indians suffer from depression, and another 38 million Indians suffer from anxiety disorders. Again, this is a huge number, 56 million Indians, okay? It is not less, it is huge. And all of these people need assistance, okay? All of these people need assistance, and we only have 3 psychiatrists. Okay. And India also accounts 36.6% of suicides globally. Okay. And again, 36.6 is not a lesser number. It is again a huge number. Okay. And in India, the economic loss due to mental health conditions between 2012 to 2030 is $1.03 trillion of 2010 dollars. Okay, so someone, if you're good at numbers, you can convert it to now. So 1.3 trillions of amount is again is a huge number. Okay, so yeah, moving on to the next slide. Yes, as we were talking about physical health, mental health, and emotional health are intertwined, interconnected. Body, mind, spirit, and soul are also interconnected. one cannot work without the other. Okay. And change is an inevitable part of our life. Correct? It is change happens every day to everybody in some form or the other. Okay. There's a huge list which we cannot control in our control or change in our life. Okay. I have a few things which we cannot change. To name few, the Mother Nature. Okay. The weather, the natural disasters, we cannot change or you cannot control. Okay. And what other people think, you cannot control that. And what other people do and what other people feel. Okay. All this, you cannot do anything about it. And your past, something which has already happened, you cannot change it. It is done. Okay. And your height, your looks, your skin color, all this we cannot change. Or you cannot control aging. Aging is something you cannot control. It happens. Okay. And most importantly, you cannot make someone to love you. Okay. They should feel it. Unless they feel it from by themselves, you cannot force them. All these we cannot change and we cannot control. But we have four things which we can change and control. Okay. As you can see, body, mind, spirit, and soul. A human can change and control only these four things in the world. Body, keep it healthy by doing physical exercise. Okay. Mind, keep it very sharp. Please do meditate. Emotions, keep it stable through all the points that we discussed earlier. Energy, keep it strong. Don't make others to influence your energy. Okay, only these four things we can have control over. I have a quote in the next slide it is also a very beautiful quote. You yourself, as much as anybody in the entire universe, deserve your love and affection, by Buddha. It is my most favorite quote. So only you can love yourself. Okay, others does love you, but you should love yourself. And moving on to the next slide. Thank you so much for your time, and thank you so much for having me with you. I end up by saying, cherish your yesterdays, dream your tomorrows, and live your todays. I'll be glad if there are any questions to answer. And thank you so much.
Wow, it was a wonderful, mind-blowing session, ma'am. What a saying, love yourself first. That was wonderful.
Thank you.
Ma'am, now I have some questions from the participants, actually.
Yes.
It's like, how parents or the teachers should help the children in tackling the mental issues or mental problems relating to studies, especially this COVID period?
You mean to say how parents and teachers can help children?
Yes.
Okay.
How should we help them?
Okay. To educate the children, first we should be educated ourselves. Like we are supposed to be well educated on the topic. I mean, about the addictions that we were talking. I mean, we are supposed to be more educated on that. We should give them a safe feeling towards us. They should feel free to discuss such topics to us. They should be very, they should not feel insecure to discuss something to us. We should make them feel better and ask them to come and talk to us. That feeling we should give them. Okay, and parents and teachers, I think teachers, they cannot do that, but parents, I think they should monitor their kids. They should keep watching what they are doing. And again, something which both parents and teachers can do is you can encourage them for the physical health. That will definitely help both mental and emotional health. As I've been saying from the beginning, physical, mental, emotional, intertwined and interconnected, you can help them to concentrate on their physical health. That will definitely help them to, you can help children by asking them to do that. Basically, keep them very busy. Keep them very busy. So I think this will help.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Ma'am, like, it's like we are all living in the anxiety disorders, like on the top, this media coverage is also triggering about COVID everywhere, death, this much death. And now how to cope up this and lead a balanced life?
Anxiety disorder is something a month back, even I was into such feelings. Okay, even I underwent such feelings with myself. There are a lot of surveys and studies which confirms that social media promotes negative feelings, and they boost our anxiety. They make us to feel worst of the fear, and so it does. Okay, we cannot deny the fact, it does. It has been proved also that social media and media affects, it gives a negative feeling. As I was telling you, a month back, even I had the same issue. I was even scared to check my WhatsApp status because it was poured with many rest in peace statuses, which I really felt bad. I couldn't take the losses of their loved ones. There was a point even where I started crying. I really couldn't take it. So, and one day I opened up and I spoke to my colleagues and my family. I don't know whether it helped, but I made a point to talk to somebody. We have to talk about it to someone. But it is true. Social media does give negative thoughts. It does push you to anxiety disorders. The first thing that I did was everybody told me to stop using social media. They told me to stop use Facebook. They told me not to look at the WhatsApp statuses. But we cannot be like that. So instead, what I did was I started gather information of the bed availability. I started gathering the information of the injection that they were looking for. And I started to share such information in my WhatsApp status so that somebody or the other will gain benefit out of it. So, I think you have to ignore the negativity and look at the positive side. Only that can help to prevent this. Because we cannot eliminate social media in our life like that, because it has become a part of our life now. Yes.
Very true, ma'am. We'll try to live in a positive environment. We should try.
Yeah.
Ma'am, like, how do I offer my emotional support to my family members or the friends or my colleagues who are like, they are quarantined? How do I support them?
Okay. First thing that we can do is we should take care of ourselves to help others. You should be strong enough first to help others. So you make yourself very strong first. Second, ask them, how can you help or how can you support? Just go to them, ask them, through phone, ask them, how can you help? Then listen to their problems fully. Don't be judgmental. Okay, so comfort them with your words and actions. More than the words, it is your voice and tone, and your body language, your facial expressions. All this convey more than the words that you're going to use. Yeah, you should give them the feelings of saying you're there to help them. You should skip advising. Generally, advising will not work at this point of time. So you're not supposed to advise. Maybe we can request them to do something, but definitely advising will not help at this time. The best thing is to talk to them. I do that. I always make sure to talk to any of my friends. And talk to them. Be gentle, be polite, and talk. Listen to them. Listen completely to them. Let them finish their problems, and then you can talk about it. Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. We will surely try to support our loved ones by our caring words.
Yes.
Thank you so only much, ma'am, for patience. Sure, ma'am. We will try to do it. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for answering patiently and so clearly to all the questions. Now over to Hema.
Thank you.
Hema, unmute.
Emma unmuted. Yeah, speaks. Emma, we can't hear you. If you are using headphone, just remove that headphone.
Sir?
Yes, ma'am. Please go ahead.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite Dr. Sriram, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, to deliver the oath of thanks. Over to Sriram, sir.
Thank you, Hema. A moment of gratitude makes a difference in your attitude. It's a great pleasure to propose the vote of thanks on behalf of Annamalai Arts and Science College. Let me first praise the Lord for making today's session a great success. At this point, I would like to express my sincere thanks to the speaker, Ms. Gomathi Rajendran, for sharing her valuable points on how to manage our emotions during this pandemic, which was very much informative and an eye-opening session for the students. Once again, thank you, ma'am. I would like to express my heartiest thanks to the management, our chairman, Chevalier Dr. N. R. Dhanapalan, our secretary, Mr. N. R. D. Premkumar, and our joint secretary, Dr. P. E. Premchand, for giving your continuous support and guidance. Thank you, sir. Further, I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to our principal, Dr. Kamala Balakrishnan, vice principal and IQAC coordinator, Mrs. Zafia Solomon, head of the department, Dr. Uma Charlada, and my department faculties for their guidance, motivation, and continuous support. My sincere thanks to our technical team for making this event as a grand success. Finally, I would like to thank all our participants and students for making this session a notable success. Once again, I thank you. I thank everyone for being with us in this informative evening. Have a great day and stay safe, stay home. Thank you.